Alright, so it looks like I've got some blue sky again today, so I'm going to actually go for a bit of a better ride, not just to the shops. Bit of bitumen to start with, and then hopefully if it's not too wet where I'm hoping to go, ride along a gravel road. It's not too far from where I live really. Should be alright. On the way there, it's like a back road out towards the area called Habana. It's a small little township sort of thing. Chucked a couple extra cameras on today, hoping that they're going to work, and mounted them on the crash bar, so not sure how they're going to go with vibrations. One facing forward, and then one facing up towards me. That's the one I'm worried the most about. Is it's just because of the angle it sits on, looks like it'd be quite vibey. The mount's not the best, so off a Sony action cam. Just seems a little bit flimsy for this sort of use. Probably fine on a bicycle, but not on a vibrating motorbike. Finally passed a bit of traffic, and now we can sort of enjoy the view. Very nice country out this way, all sort of rural. Single lane bridge, all looks pretty ordinary. And here's Havana, little township. There's not much here except for like an engineering shop and a community hall pretty much. All this only 5 minutes from the normal suburbs of Macquarie. Nice back road riding through here. Road condition isn't that flash in places though, and especially after it's rained for a long time, you need to look out for potholes. Now down to a single lane, road quality gets even worse. I've done a fair bit of exploring out here when I had the KLR, a lot of these little side roads. Unfortunately, they don't lead anywhere really exciting, as they just lead to people's properties and keep out signs all over them. So this is just the main road you can really travel on at the moment. Just slow down and let the 4B go through so I'm not following in his dust. Turn the other cameras on. Drive to prevailing conditions. This road is usually pretty good. It depends how recent they've graded it and how much rain we've had through here. I do like this little overpass here for photos. Unfortunately, it's hard to see traffic coming, so you line everything up for a photo and then a car comes, and you've got to wait for the dust to clear and take more photos. This is only a short section of dirt road, just to join up two bits of bitumen. I think they've intentionally left this unpaved just so it doesn't become a major roadway, make people use the highway more. That's a good little shortcut to where I want to go. Too many potholes, so that's good. They're a little bit rutted out, but not bad. So, sort of going towards C4, but there's a dirt road that goes down past the boat ramp and heads towards Cape Hillsborough, which is just before C4. The only thing I've got to look out for is the turn off to the dirt road if I don't overshoot it. So this is the road. Shit, and it's the other thing on this road that further along it's unfenced farmland, so the dodge cow shit as well as cows. There's constant creek boat ramp. Hardly anyone here. There's been a fair few croc sightings here recently. A lot more cow shit than I thought. Been a fair bit of rain here by the looks, but the road nice and dry. Hopefully with the rain that's been here it keeps the dust down a bit. So at the moment I'm riding in sports 3 mode, the DCT, and I've got the traction control on the lowest setting. Sports 3 is my favorite mode to ride in. It keeps the engine more lively. It's pretty much hammered now. When I turn the bike on and go to ride, I just put it straight to sports 3. There's a good thing with the DCT is you can override it. If you think it's revving a bit high, you just click it up a gear. A little bit skatey here. I don't know if it picks up on the camera or well, but there's a lot of loose gravel on the top of this road. This is probably the first proper dirt road that I actually went on when I had the KLR. When I first got it, it was a little bit scary and rough, and after a while you think, what was I so worried about? It's pretty easy, this road. Cows ahead. First water crossing. Wouldn't even be an inch deep. There you go, I can make another video now. First water crossing on the Africa Twin. We've got another one here. There's no water across this one. This is a pretty common sight whenever you're out on back roads across creeks. So creeks are actually usually pretty small. They don't build bridges, they just build little concrete overpass things. When they get heavy rain, they just flood a bit. when I come through here on the KLR, the biggest fear was one of these things is just going to jump up and sort of come at me. Geez, it's massive. Pretty timid. They're usually more scared of the bike than what you are of it. Bit of traffic. Of him. Yeah, there's a fair bit of cattle here. And there's going to run away from me. And where's this one going to go? Check out the bike. There's a few little different roads that are out here, but mostly dead end and at people's properties. There is one turn off that's up further, Belmunda, that goes through a real tiny little community, when you could call it. Nothing really to see there except a couple of shacks. But it is a good ride down that way. Might go that way on the way back. I think that's down that way. Have a look on the way back. Let's go to Cape Hillsborough first. So Cape Hillsborough, it's a national park up against the water, really, on the coastline there. It's not like a little bit of a point. Here we go, a little bit more water. Oh, no, it's just damp. It's got an old volcano there that's extinct. But yeah, National Park, you can't ride in there. There's a lot of walking trails and stuff. You go down to the beach, it's a nice spot. Just can't do any motorbike riding through there. There is rangers and stuff there all the time too, so you can't just have a sneak in. And it's pretty rough and hilly anyway, for this sort of bike anyway. Probably be fun on something like a trials bike. Notice when I come into them little overpass things, if I'm on the rear brake, you can feel the ABS pulsing through the pedal. I've still got the rear ABS on, obviously. Like now, you can feel it pulse a little bit there. Tire just loves this sort of road, like just grips, just holds on and shoots you in the direction you want to go. It's really nice. Pretty much at the end of the dirt by now. Not as much further to go. End of the dirt. Cape Hillsborough, turn right. Another little road that goes down, it's all dirt, all down to the beach. I went there on the KLR. That'd be pretty shit ass to ride through there at the moment. I went through it in the KLR and it hadn't rained for a bit. There was still a bit of standing water there. Might go down that way on the Africa Twin once it's dried out a bit. One of the bad things about riding on your own is if you get stuck, you're all by yourself, you need to pull the bike out or something like that. You're stuck under the bike. Might bring Scott on his Tiger 800 out here. So the road to Cape Hillsborough from all here is all bitumen. Pretty sure it's all bitumen until you actually get to the park itself. Parking area and the little shop that's there. It's only real, actually it's quite small, this Cape Hillsborough. It's just very hilly, so it makes it seem bigger when you're walking through it all. Like I said, it's mainly walking track. Can't take a motorbike anywhere. Cape Hillsborough. So the area where I live in Queensland, in Australia, has got a lot of these little national parks spread around. This is probably one of the more well-known in my area. It's probably one of the more visited ones. Down to 20K. It's probably the big tourism thing for where I live, even though tourism isn't massive, but it's like the natural stuff is what brings people to the area where I live. Barrier Reef and National Park land and all that sort of stuff. So the beach is just over there. You can't see it from here. It's on a little bit of a rise here, but just past that vegetation there is the beach. Where this is, all the schools do trips here and camps here and stuff. You can camp here. There's kangaroos and stuff everywhere, bush turkeys. There's the beach down there. Can't go down there. See what's down here. There are kangaroos, wallabies. I think you realise how close I was. There's usually a ton of them around because all of the tourists feed them. There you go, not recommended for two-wheel drive vehicles. Well, I'm one-wheel drive, so I'll be fine. There's been a fair bit of rain here. The ground's still quite damp. Never actually been down this way. Only been as far as the campsite on motorbike. Can't be too far because the GPS says that the ocean's just over here. bike revving a bit because I'm in sports 3, so it tries and holds the revs higher. It's good because whenever I need to give the throttle a stab, it's in the meat of the torque range. Yeah, the bike's never labouring. Hopefully the video comes through good on these other cameras. Very disappointed. This looks like it. So it looks like I did tell a bit of a lie, you can actually ride through some of this. I don't think you'll see it on the camera, just through there. Try and find a clear spot. Here you go. There you go. You can walk down further, but I'm not going to get off the bike. I'm too lazy for that. But you can see it's on a little bit of a point. This Cape Hillsborough, surrounded by water on three sides. Hey, a nice little road. Back, let's try gravel mode. And traction control off. Let's turn the rear ABS off as well. Now let's watch me crash my bike. So in G mode, what I've noticed is the clutch engages just a little bit quicker at low revs. I didn't notice anything when I did a different dirt road the other week at high speed. Didn't know any difference at all, only taking off. So now I'm in crawling along in second gear. There's less slippage of the clutches. So it's not slipping here, it's just using engagement of the clutch and the torque of the bike to get up these risers. I don't think they look real steep on camera, but they're a little bit steep. I don't really see the need for a full drive here except for some of these bumps here. Ground clearance would be an issue, but most two-wheel drive utes would get through here pretty easy. Bike is just, it looks heavy on paper. You look at paper, on paper it says it's 260 kilos, and how the hell would you ever ride that apart from bitumen? And then you ride it and the weight just seems to disappear. I'm sure very low speed stuff where you're putting your foot down all the time, you're probably going to know that it's a heavy bike. But this sort of riding, which I'm guessing the bike was primarily designed for, doesn't feel heavy. Just Honda's done an awesome job on just making everything good on this bike. And slow back down when I crawl past the campground so I don't piss anyone off. Mile out exhaust, there you go, wallaby. I they can be quite friendly, and on the other end they can be quite mean, but the ones that come up close to the campground are usually quite friendly because they just want your food. You're not encouraged to feed them either. So that was Cape Hillsborough that I could show you on a motorbike. Close that back up so you don't get blasted with wind noise. So now gravel mode's no good to me. I can't turn it off on the fly. So take the throttle off and you can turn it off, righto. So if you're moving along at speed, take your hand off the throttle, roll the throttle off completely and you can turn it off. What about ABS? Must have to come to a stop to turn rear ABS on. Up behind me, so I'll just pull up in the middle of the road like an idiot. Bike setting zero. Everybody in neutral. You gotta hold the button in for a bit longer. Learn something every day. Or I could have just read the manual. Reading the manual is not as fun as being out here. And of course, traction control. You can pretty much turn that to whatever mode you want. I've noticed it's actually quite savage in like traction control 3. If you're on a little bit of a dirt and you go purposely to spin the tyres, it kills the fun straight away. The bike sounds terrible when it does it, like it's all backfiring and popping and all that sort of stuff. Until you back off and it regains traction again. So I'm guessing traction control 3 is probably good to ride on the wet. Well, if you're on a very, very, very slippery surface, like wet clay sort of stuff, and you don't want to spin at all. I've ridden on that stuff, it's not fun at all. That's where I dropped the KLR the first time, up at Yungala, that wet clay soil stuff. Just no grip at all. Didn't help that I had a bald rear tyre as well. Really glad I actually got out on the bike today. When I got up this morning, it was spinning a bit, and I thought, this is going to be, you know, another rainy day. And it's magically cleared to blue sky. I think the rain's gone for good. There's a couple of clouds around that look a bit dark, but make the most of it while I can. For now, I'm going to go down to. Back to the turn off on the dirt road. And I'm going to take the turn off towards the Belmunda. A few other little tracks through there, full of water. This Belmunda as well, there is a couple of tracks that go off the main dirt road. That'd be all full of water. I'll bring Scotty back this way a few weeks time if the rain stops. Should be able to go down that way, but the road there is really rough and there's just people that dump shit everywhere, so you gotta be careful with your tyres. Trucks on here, I've never seen that many trucks through here before. And I didn't slow down to go through that water and I just splashed water on my pants. Cattle. Bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. Run it out. is the turn off to Belmunda. It's actually a little, it is like a clearing. It's perfect for mucking around on motorbikes. No technical stuff, it's just all open area. Cow shit. Slow down for the cattle grid, I think. Traction control kicking in a bit there. Front wheel gets unloaded, the rear wheel gets unloaded a bit when you're on the power. This is the area I was talking about, but it's a lot of water on it at the moment. Usually when this is dry, you can see motorbike tire marks all through that. This is the end of that Constance Creek, I think. Go all the way up to this little community. I'm not sure what it's really called. It's not a township or anything, it's just a bunch of houses up against the water. There's a few tracks in there. It's way too wet to go in that. That'll be wet for weeks now. This is Belmunda. See, it's houses. And beach access. Over there's Cape Hillsborough. The traction control kicked in here, popping fart around. Be a good photo opportunity. Let's see how shitty this ground is. So, taking a few happy snaps on the phone. Car there that's nearly disappeared, another one further down. So as you can see, when it is dry, you can actually put vehicles out on here. But it must be like a bit of a floodplain when it rains. So I don't really feel like trying to get my motorcycle out of a big bog today, so this is as far as I'll go. Stick to the gazetted roads. Loving the bike. It's just awesome on this sort of stuff. It's actually not as dirty as I thought it would be after riding where it has been today, but still get it clean when it gets home. Try and look after it. A lot of the dirt off the rear tyres seems to get stuck underneath the bike, doesn't flick up everywhere. It's good, well thought out. And does go in for its service tomorrow. I think it's only just clicked 1,000 k's today. Let's have a look. 999, so I've got 1 kilometre to go. So I'll get home, I'll put another 20 something kilometres on it. And then goes in for a service tomorrow. That's all booked in. Just got to ring them to make sure that they've got the other filter for the DCT. So this model, the DCT model, uses two oil filters. You got the normal engine oil filter, and then there's another smaller filter which goes in here, and that's for the clutch. So it's got its own separate filter. But I'll have to try and find the part number out for the clutch filter to see if it's common to any other motorcycles or ATVs or anything. When I went in the other day to book the service in, they said they had to order that filter in. So they also sell ATVs and stuff, so must be a unique filter. So enough sitting around, starting to get a bit warm, not moving around in this jacket, so kick the bike in and we'll head back home. A lot of cane out this way as well. It was the biggest industry in the town, or Mackay anyway, until sort of mining took over. I think probably changed since now, that at one point in time Mackay did make the most sugar in Queensland, probably Australia. There's definitely a lot of cane around. And back onto the main dirt road. These train tracks that cut across the road at an angle. Never know which way they're going to run. And back to the proper boat ramp. Very rough through here. Hopefully this video has been a lot more exciting than our little trip to the shops. I just wanted to get something out there. You don't realise how fast you're going with this DCT because you're not clicking through the gears. You come out of a corner and give it a bit of throttle, you end up going a lot quicker than what you think you are. Yeah, we're back on the bitumen again for the final time. And back into town. Well, thanks for watching this video. I hope to do a lot more like these. Go to all the little different areas around town where I can ride on dirt. Go off road. So it was a quick ride. Go on for a little bit over, probably an hour, hour and a half. I'll go home and edit this video. Put it up, plan the next ride. Hopefully next day is off. Thanks.